The clash followed RDC Hakim Kirigwa's intervention in a protest organized by residents. They planned to walk from their homes to the factory and then to the Njeru Municipality Council offices to petition the town clerk over the black suit. Athena Semambo, the area councillor, says the black suit stays on surfaces. Even water and crops have not been spared.
You cannot iron. The water that we are taking is totally dirty. When you look at the whole place, it is being dumped. It's now, we are a dumping area for bagasse and their ash. Sincerely, for our resolution is we want them to stop it immediately as they put things right, but not to tell us that please wait for 6 months as we suffer. We have our right. Sincerely, we have so many people who have fallen free. We have had accidents that are coming because of this ash. When this thing splashes in your eyes, the next day you cannot even look at something.
Semambo says they have tried to engage the Indian owners of the factory and the police, but all in vain.
We shall march to the people we elected. We have the mayors, they are there. We have the ministers, they are there. We can even go to the parliament. We are planning to go to the parliament. I myself, I will lead people to go to the parliament. If they don't work on anything from that whatever, from that meeting, I'm going to lead my people. We shall go to the parliament. And as we go to the parliament, that's where we shall struggle.
He wants the RDC to order closure of the factory until measures are put in place to manage the air pollution. Some residents accused area police of siding with the investors at their expense.
Several times we have had meetings, but they are not listening. Even of recent, we had a meeting and they decided that to end this kind of fate, let us just move for 6 months, they will put things right. Which is impossible, because as a community we are suffering, we are greatly suffering. You cannot iron, the water that we are taking is totally dirty.
The RDC was forced to call for a meeting at the Njeru Municipal Council. During the meeting, the investors were asked to explain what they have done to rectify the problem. After the meeting, the Njeru Environment Officer, John Busiko, said the investors were ordered to close half of the factory and install machines in 3 months to curb pollution.
Immediately, they cut their production of the boiler to a half to avoid any misty flying of ash out of their premises. Then permanently, we've given them a period of 3 months to construct and install a wet scrapper, which is going to trap all the flying ash without flying to the community.
Busiko explained that the suit itches once it lands on the skin. He said some businesses near the factory have been forced to close because they cannot coexist with the factory due to pollution. Report by Emmanuel Barukusa for the news.